You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Sunday, the 19th of June, 2022, the solemnity of Corpus Christi, body and blood of Christ, the center of our faith, the reason why I can say I'm still standing, because my focus is on the Eucharist and the power that Eucharist has in my own life. I don't know about you, but we have to understand that Eucharist will only make sense when we understand that there is breaking in it. He took the bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples. Participating in the proclamation of the word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Lubuto Kunda, a seminarian at Mukasa Minor Seminary in Choma, Zambia, child of Albertina and Josephat Kunda from Lusaka, Zambia, text for us the first reading. Gloria Brightness, child of Mrs. Hilda and Mr. Florence from Dar es Salaam, Tanzania, text for us the responsorial psalm. Hilda Atieno Obuya from Nairobi, Kenya, text for us the second reading. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Benedictus Mulenga Nshikita, celebrating his priestly anniversary today. A Society of African Missions missionary working in Toronto, Canada. Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption. Who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. He brought out bread and wine. A reading from the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 14, verse 18 to 20. In those days, Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought out bread and wine. He was priest of God Most High. And he blessed Abraham and said, Blessed be Abraham, by God Most High, maker of heaven and earth, and blessed be God Most High, who has delivered your enemies into your hand. And Abraham gave him a tenth of everything. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm 110, verse 1, 2, 3, and 4. Response is taken from Psalm 110, verse 4b. And the response is, You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The Lord's revelation to my Lord, sit at my right hand, until I make your foes your footstool.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The Lord will send the Zion, your script of power, rule in the midst of your foes.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
With you in priestly rule on the day of your power in holy splendor. From the womb before the dawn, I have begot you.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The Lord has sworn an oath he will not change. You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
Second reading, as often as you eat this bread and drink the chalice, you proclaim the Lord's death. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 to verse 26. Brethren, I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way also with the chalice, after supper, saying, "This chalice is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink the chalice, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
All ate and were satisfied. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 9, verses 11b to 17. At that time, Jesus spoke to the crowds of the kingdom of God and cured those who had need of healing. Now the day began to wear away, and the 12 came and said to him, "Send the crowds away to go into the villages and the country round about to lodge and get provisions, for we are here in a lonely place." He said to them, "Give them something to eat." They said, "We have no more than 5 loaves and 2 fish, unless we are to go and buy food for all these people." For they were about 5,000 men. And he said to his disciples, "Make them sit down in companies, about 50 each. And so they did, and made them all sit down. And taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven, and blessed and broke them, and gave them to the disciples to set before the crowd. And all ate and were satisfied. And they took up what was left over, 12 baskets of broken pieces." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy Solemnity of Corpus Christi. And I suppose in many parts of the world, they will be showing off Christ around the villages, around our location, around our setting, to make sure that Christ is known by others in the Eucharist. But it is good to understand what we mean by the Eucharist, what we actually celebrate, and what Christ insisted we should be celebrating. The first account that we ever heard about the Eucharist was given by Paul. Paul was the first one to write about the events that took place on the night before he suffered, because there were no gospels at the time Paul was writing the letter to the Corinthians. And he tells the Corinthians what he received, what he was taught. So before any gospel was written, people were receiving things through oral tradition. And Paul received by oral tradition what he now shares in writing. "For I received from the Lord what I also delivered to you." I am here to tell you what I was told, and this is exactly what happened. Because of the importance of that event, Paul had to remind the Corinthians who had not understood the Eucharist to make it clear to them that the Eucharist is about being broken. Why was it telling the Corinthian community this? It is because there was trouble in that Corinthian community. People used to gather for the celebration of the Eucharist every Sunday. They would meet on the first day of the week to celebrate this breaking of the bread. And in order for them not to take advantage of that breaking of the bread as a means to satisfy themselves, since it was just supposed to be symbolic, they started by eating first. They would have a meal and then they go to the Eucharist. But then they thought to themselves, why can't we be having the meals together? Instead of just eating at home, we come and eat where we are having the Eucharist, because this is communion. This is the sharing in the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. So they started doing that. But an unfortunate situation occurred. Somebody would bring beef, another one brings a carpenter, the small fish. And now, because of this, there was separation. The rich had to have a meal somewhere, and the poor would eat what they brought. And that segregation, that classy separation, was very harmful to the church. And when this was reported to Paul, he now decided to explain to them what the Eucharist is all about. He says, listen, for I received from the Lord what I delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it. The essence, the value, the importance, the stress is on breaking it. He would have just given it to them like that to break for themselves. No, he broke it himself. He broke it and said, this is my body, which is for you. How? Because I am going to be broken for you. I will be shared by the whole world. Do this in remembrance of me. Doing this is not just about performing an act, but doing this in our own lives, becoming broken for others. That's what it means. To do this is to become broken for others. There is no way you are going to be a man or a woman who participates in the Eucharist and you remain selfish, you remain stingy. No, you have to learn to break yourself for the world. And so, in the same way, the chalice, this is a new covenant in my blood. Again, blood had to flow from him. It was not like a remote control thing. No, his own blood came out of him for the world. Sacrifice here. Heroism here is the meaning of the Eucharist. If you don't understand this aspect, you're not going to understand the readings as we have them today. They are just speaking about self-giving. They are just speaking about sharing. The first reading tells us over Abraham. Abraham comes back from a victorious mission dealing with those who had actually kidnapped his own nephew, Lot. And after dealing with them, becoming victorious, he even gained something from that victory. And on his way, he came to Salem. Salem, peace. Salem was actually Jerusalem. And the king who was there was Melchizedek, who was also a priest. And when he arrived there, Abraham was hungry. He needed something to eat. And the king of Salem, Melchizedek, showed what it means to share. He brought out bread and wine. And it is because of this that will come Melchizedek, the high priest. Priest in the order of Melchizedek, being in a position to share bread and wine. And he brings out that bread and wine to give to Abraham. And he blessed Abraham for the victory. He shares. And wait, it doesn't end there. Abraham, who recognized that that victory was won by God, decided to give a tenth of all that he had. Tithe. Tithe is only done by people who recognize that victory is won through God himself. It is God who makes you succeed. It is God who makes you rich where you are. It is never given by people who don't understand this aspect. No, tithe is only given by those who have understood that whatever they have, wherever they have reached, is the hand of God at work. And so they want to recognize that. And in recognizing that, they offer a tenth of what they receive. This has come from you, and to you I give back. So, if you have to understand the context of Eucharist, you will have to know that in sharing, you are recognizing that everything you have comes from God. And so you are humble enough to bring at the disposal all that you have been given for others to share. Melchizedek does that. Abraham does that with that tithe. And Jesus in today's gospel shows the disciples how they are supposed to be like him, broken for others. The disciples are with Jesus in a deserted place. And the apostles come to Jesus to say, send these people away so that they go and look for food. That's the easiest thing to do. Yes, to send them away. Let them fend for themselves so that we remain relaxed. Nothing to break ourselves for. No, let them take care of themselves. You see what happens? This is exactly what happens. Jesus does not allow that to happen, and he doesn't want that to happen in our world today. He wants the world to be Eucharistic-centered in spirituality. He broke himself up for the world, and he wants us to break ourselves up for the world. Give them something to eat yourselves. Oh no, it cannot happen. Look at this, Jesus. We only have a few loaves. Only a few loaves and a few fish. What is that for so many? We have no more than 5 loaves and 2 fish. No more than, like saying, we don't have anything much. That's all we have. And now you are telling us to feed these thousands? No. That's exactly what happens to a stingy person. To a stingy person who doesn't understand the meaning of the Eucharist, there will never be anything enough in this world. There will always be something to complain about. Even time is not enough for me to share with others. Oh no, you want me to do this? By the way, I don't have any time, not even a minute, I don't have. And yet, I spend time on addictive games the whole day, and I cannot just spare a minute to listen to a brother. I cannot just spare a minute to go a mile with somebody who is in depression. The disciples have to be taught that they have to break themselves for others. Our world would change today if we understood the real gospel message, if we understood the real meaning of the Eucharist. It is learning to break ourselves for others, even with the little that we have. We may not have too much, but that little that we have, we break it for others. You only learn to break yourself for others when, upon giving something, you feel the pinch. You feel something has been taken away from you. Not when you give something, you say, oh, I was just waiting for a moment to get rid of this shirt. I was just waiting for a moment to get rid of these shoes because they are not fitting me well. That is not giving. Giving is when you take out that pair of shoes that you know very well is your favorite. That is giving. That is breaking yourself. I tell you, it's not easy. Oh, yes, it's not easy. But it comes to people who have understood what the Eucharist means. Jesus asks them to sit down to relax. Because he knows what he's going to do. Because he knows what he does best. He makes them sit down there. And as they sit down there, he now gives thanks. Because Eucharist is a thanksgiving meal. Thanking God for his provision. Thanking God for everything he has done in our lives. That's why when we are celebrating the Eucharist, there must be a thanksgiving song after the Eucharist. There is no way you can claim to be celebrating the Eucharist if at the end of the reception of the Eucharist, there is no thanksgiving song, because that's the essence of the Eucharist. And so he gave thanks, gave the bread and shared it with them. And I suppose the disciples were looking at that sign and saying, wow, what a mighty man. No, he was not just doing it for a show. He was making us understand how we are going to take care of each other. He was making us understand how we are going to end poverty. Poverty will end in our world today when we learn to break ourselves for others. Poverty will end in our world today when I get into an office with the intention of saving other people, not with the intention of amassing wealth for myself. No, it is selflessness. We need Eucharistic-centered people in our world today. People who are able to think about what can make our world better than what can make themselves richer. No, it is about the whole world to benefit. And we want the whole world to reach that average good living where at least everyone is able to afford 2 meals a day. At least 2 meals a day. I'm not talking about 5 meals. I'm not talking about 4 meals. I'm talking about 2 meals a day. Because there are people going hungry. There are people who don't even have a meal a day because somebody's having 10 meals a day somewhere and does not even think about others. May this Eucharistic message touch our lives. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Sunday to you and happy Feast of Corpus Christi.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I
darkness.